So my data, CSV data, is located in dbase file. Double click to open it. This window will help you select the rows and the columns that you need. Another thing which is crucial for this thing is to check the sampling period or the sampling time of your data. Most of data logging devices will give the sampling period or the sampling time. This will help us later. Then you click on import selection. So now your selection is in the workspace. You double click on your data from the workspace. Then now you have your data right here. You can try to plot it just to confirm that you have the right kind of data by clicking on selecting two columns, for example, and going into plot and plotting it. So now I see that I'm plotting the signal I was hoping for, so I know I have the right kind of data. So now we have to name each column. For example, the first column is time. I know it's time. The second column is current. I know it's current. The third one is voltage. Call it voltage. Fourth one is DC voltage. And the last one is the DC current. So now that I have named each column from my workspace, remember, still here in the workspace, I use a function called time series. So I call my variable, my time series variable, I call it best variable, best var. Then I type time series. Then I open parentheses, then I put first the signal and then the time. No worries, you have the script. But basically, the first thing you type is the name of your data, dot, the name of the signal, comma, name of the data, dot, time. Then you send, you run this script. Now in a workspace, we have a variable called, a time series variable called best variable. Now we open Simulink. We search from a block called from workspace. Then into this block, we select our variable, so which is called best var. Then we put our sampling period. Remember the crucial parameter I told you to hold into memory was 0.0001. You put it here, then click OK. Then you search for a scope, link the scope. Then we run the simulation. And now we have our signal. We can check that it looks like the one we had before, to make sure that we are plotting the right kind of signal. So now into our scope, we can change, we can log the data as structure with time variable. Let's go into scope. Logging, I call this variable best scope, type structure with time. Then you apply, and this will send a structure with time variable into the workspace. And then with this block from Simscape electrical specialized power system called PowerGI, you can do an FFT analysis. And basically this would take the data we sent from our scope, and we try to analyze by making an FFT analysis. So you put the right frequency minus 50 Hertz, max frequency, I chose 2500. Then I compute. So now I can see my FFT analysis. Last bonus, we can go back into our MATLAB window. Here we find, here we can plot, we can make beautiful plots of our data and signals by using something called tiled layout. So basically you have the, you will have the script, but it works the same as a classic plotting tool, but you can have control and you can place them as you wish. Basically, I have plotted all my signals, and I think basically there is a, there must be a more efficient way to do this, but I don't know how to do it. So if you know, please don't hesitate to share.